Hey everybody, good morning, welcome to the garden here. It's Sunday morning, June 22nd, as far as I know, and I just got here last night, and crazy deer stuff. The deer have actually been hitting a lot of the trees. They've been nibbling the trees. Let me show you something here. They took off this this apple tree right here. Was totally covered with leaves. It was totally covered with green. And now this is all that's left. The deer really, really hit it. Because what happens is I set it all up and then I go away and there's no one really here to watch over it all the time. I mean, my parents come up and they water and everything like that, and that's great, but you really need someone up here to really guard it. Because they're, I mean, this is just like a buffet all of a sudden for them. All these plants and vegetables. Surprisingly, they really haven't hit much of the other veggies in the actual garden. They seem to like the fruit trees a lot more than anything. Let me show you this right here. I'm doing a little row of kamut grass right here, right along the pathway as we walk in. We're gonna put like sand in here so it shows like a nice difference. But yeah, this is what we've got so far. All the melons are gonna go along this fence, and then we've got all the tomatoes going along the back row here, and they're gonna climb up a trellis that we're gonna put in. And then yeah, so we've got like all of our peppers and herbs, and there's a lot of cauliflower and cabbage and basil. It's pretty nice. We got blueberries in the back over here, the row of raspberries, but there's still a ton of planting to do. There's at least 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. There's at least like 13 or 14 more square foot beds to plant stuff into. It's gonna be a lot of work. To scare the deer away, we're putting some soap on a rope. The scent is supposed to scare them away. And then I'm just gonna put tin foil, hang that around, and just try and like, you know, I don't know, urinate along the border to hopefully scare them away with my scent. I don't know. When it comes to food, it's a whole different game. It's funny enough, they didn't eat any of the grass, any of the kamut grass. They just ate the trees. The bees are doing really well. Let me take you over to the bees here. This is where we're walking down into where the greenhouse is going to be, and this is the temporary spot of the bees. And eventually we're going to move the bees to another area, but for now this is a good spot for them. This hive, we had to add on another level because it was really, really getting crowded. As you can see, there's still like a lot of crowding at the bottom of this hive. They're both doing really well though. I mean, they're obviously active. Bees are flying everywhere. Things are good. I'm really happy with that. And we've got some more rows of trees in the back here. And then the rows of trees in the front. Haven't, you know, we can't really put grass in yet in the front here because they're still gonna be putting the deck in, like, so they need to drive up here with their vehicles and do all that. And then today I'm gonna be planting some transplants that I bought at the green market at Union Square. These are gonna be going into the garden today. So that's where we're at. All right, guys, thank you for watching, and lots more to come. Thanks a lot. See you soon. Bye.